Hi children, in this video we are going to see 13th chapter graphs. So under this graph x is 1, using tally mark we are going to do the sum. X is 1, first question, complete the table showing the result of a survey of class 5 students. Answer the questions below. So an activity is being done among the students in class 5, that is favorite after school activities. So the activities are given: watching TV, reading story books, playing indoor games, playing outdoor games, sleeping. So these tally marks can be counted each line as one number of students. So here, based on this information, three questions is asked. So before moving to the question, we'll just count this tally marks and we'll write the number of students here. So watching TV, the favorite activity, the number of students are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So 12 students under class 5 like the activity which watching TV. Reading story book, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 10 number of students. Playing indoor games, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So again 12 number of students. Playing outdoor games, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. So 18 number of students. Sleeping is 2 people. Just 2 students. So now we'll go with the questions. A question, which is the most favorite activity? So here, 18 number of students like the activity of playing outdoor games. So playing outdoor games. Which two activities are equally popular? 12. Here also 12. So equally popular is watching TV and indoor game. So watching TV and indoor games. Third question, how many students were survived? That is totally how many students this activity is being done. So here if I add, we'll get 54 total number of students. So the number of students were surveyed is 54 students. Okay, we'll go with the second exercise. So here under second exercise, we are going to see with the topic circle graph. So under exercise 2, I'm going to do the third sum. The librarian of a school conducted a survey of 100 children to find the kind of books they would like in the library. Using the data below, draw the circle graph by coloring the correct sections of the given circle. So the data which are given is, these are the 4 different books, storybook, self-help books, textbooks and encyclopedias. So number of students liked by the storybook and all is given, 40, 20, 10 and 30. So we need to find the fractions of the total. So here the total number of students surveyed was 100. So in question itself they have given. So if you add these 4 also, you will get 100. So now first let us the number of students is there, no, that we will include in the circle. So storybook was 40. So 20, 10 and 30. So among these 4 different story, that is books, 40 is the maximum number of students liked for the story book. So here the maximum space is given here. So this 40 I'm writing here, okay, which is story book books. So next greatest value, or that is greatest number of students, is 30. So 30 means next highest space is here, 30. So that is encyclopedias. Okay, next is 20. So if you compare these two, this is bigger than this. So this is 20 I am giving. So self-help books. So I'll just write SH books. Okay. So the finally the space which is there for textbook, which is 10 number of students. Okay. So now the circle graph which is given is we have that is chosen the space which is given for us. So now to find the fractions for each books, the number of students should be divided by the total number of students. 20 by 100. See, 40 people, that is 40 students like storybook. So to find the fraction 40 by 100, this 100 is total number of students. So 20 by 100, 10 by 100, 30 by 100. So if we divide 40 by 100, you'll get 2 by 5. So 20 by 100, you'll get 1 by 5. 10 by 100, you'll get 1 by 10. 30 by 100, you'll get 3 by 10. That is, we'll just cancelling the zeros, the numerator and denominator, the remainder I have written 3 by 10. So here, 10, 10 cancel means 1 by 10. So here if you take 20 one time, 20 5 times, you will get 100. So that is why 1 by 5. So here 22s are is 40, 25s are is 100. So that is why 2 by 5. Okay. So next we will see with the line graph. So under line graph, exercise 3, we are going to see with the first sum. The table is a record of Deepak's weight from the time he was born. So these are the data which are they given. So month from the birth, first month, second sum, second month, third month, fourth month, fifth month and sixth month. The weight when he born, the day when he born was 3.5 kg. So the first month, after first month 4.5, after second month 5.5, after third month 6.5. So like that they have given till 6 months. Okay. So now, so the graph sheet is being given in your textbook itself. That is here below the sleeping line, if you see here, time in months. So the months is being given here and towards the standing line. Vertical line, no? So this is treated as a weight in kg. So the weight is treated as here. So if you take, see, each and every square box will be a great, that is darker square box. Okay. So here, from here, the first box is left and the second box is treated as 1. Again, the next box is left, the third, the fourth box is treated as 2. So if you take, the scale will be from 0 to 1. Okay. So the one box, that is one square, each unit will be 0.5. Okay. So now what happens in the month of 0 when he born? What was his weight? 3.5 kg. So, 0 in the month, 3.5 in the weight. See, this is month line, this is weight line. Okay, so 0 month. So, this is month. In month, where is 0? Here. Okay, under weight, this is a weight line. Under weight, 3.5. So, this is 1, 2, 3 and 3.5 is the middle line which is going, no? That is. So that is why they have kept this red line here, 3.5. 0, 3.5. So next, 1 in the month. This is a month, 1. What is the weight? 4.5. So this 1, 2, 3, 4 and 4.5. So next, second month, 5.5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. See, this is the fifth and 5.5. This is the 5.5. Okay. So likewise, third month 6.5. 6.5. Fourth month, 7 kg. So exactly here, 7. Fifth month, 7.5. 7, so this is 7.5. So sixth month, 8. This is exactly 8 kg. So after keeping the dot, we are going to use scale to join these dots. Okay. So now I'm going to join all the dots. So each and every line, when you draw, hold your scale tightly. So that's it. This is your line graph. So if you want, you can also circle the dot wherever you have done. Okay, so based on these information, certain questions were asked. The first question is, what was Deepak's weight when he was born? When he was born, the weight is 3.5 kg. So next, what was his increase in weight? Increase in weight after 3 months. See, this is when he born. After 3 months, it is 3.6. When he was born itself, the weight was 3.5. So that we have to subtract 6.5 kg minus 3.5 kg. So that we'll get, when you subtract, you'll get 3 kg as an answer. So how much weight did he gain in the first 6 months? See, if you take first 6 months means here. So that is after 6 months, he got 8 kg. His weight was 8 kg. But when he born, the weight was 3.5. That is 3.5 kg. So that we have to deduct 3.5 from this 8 kg. That is 8 kg minus 3.5 kg. So if you minus, you will get 4.5. 4.5 kg. So last question, guess what his weight will be after 7 months. So this is still 6 months after, that is the weight was given. So after 7 months, what will be his weight? So if you see, gradually from we born, every month the weight was increased with 0.5 kg. 0.5 kg if you see, gradually it was increasing. So that we can guess, the after 6 month, that is also we can have like 8.5, that is 5 kg, that is 0.5 kg weight will be increased. It is a guessing only. Okay, so hope you have understood. Thank you, children.